Hey, it's Azure Friday. We're talking with Corey from the Virtual Machines team.
Excellent. How are you, Scott?
I'm
really nice.
Because you're wonderful. Here. You're here to cause me trouble.
That's good. I wore cologne today, so.
I appreciate that. Yeah. I've got lots of virtual machines now.
Okay.
It's a management nightmare.
Yeah.
I've got 8 virtual machines now. I know I can manage them from here.
Yeah.
What are the different ways that I can start, stop, delete, shut down, connect to virtual machines?
So, you know, in addition to the great portal experience, right, we also have the command line. So we have both PowerShell and we have the cross-platform command line, which is based on Node, right? And we can show both of those.
And cross-platform means not just Mac and Linux, but it works on...
It does work on
and
Linux,
And that's actually
too.
My preferred one. I know you like the PowerShell
Well,
one.
I mean, yeah, I'm a PowerShell guy.
You can show me the PowerShell one.
Deal.
I will show you the cross-platform.
We'll see who wins.
Okay.
Okay. Cool. We'll let the audience vote. The other aspect of Visual Studio actually has recently released support to be able to manage this, and you've got this right up right here.
Yeah, I just actually clicked here, connect to Windows Azure.
Beautiful.
I logged in.
Yep.
So you don't necessarily have to get certificates anymore.
Right.
And then, Ersi, there's the discourse form that we made for you earlier.
Yeah.
And I noticed this actually recently. I didn't know this happened, but
it shows the endpoints. It does.
Which is pretty sweet.
Very cool.
Yeah, I thought that was cool.
You to immediately sort of detect the SSH versus RDP. And in fact, if you go to a Windows one, I think you should be able to RDP directly into it.
Yeah, this one here. Yeah, see? Connect to remote desktop.
Perfect. Exactly.
So that's cool. So it's funny, as nice as the portal is, I'm spending less and less time in the portal.
Yeah, I feel a little bad.
No. For the portal guys. But,
Whatever's easy. Whatever's easy.
No, this is easier for me. And this is the same place that I already look for my servers and my other database stuff.
So. Well, and the nice thing even is for the dev test experience, this also has the ability to sort of do this debugging capability as well, right? So you can actually connect and debug into these things as
well. Yeah, exactly. So I'll remote into one and then I'll deploy to it. I mean, and the virtual machines I use less than websites.
Okay, well, I didn't.
Well, websites run on virtual
machines.
Thank you.
No, this is, thank you for your time.
But I absolutely depend on and really actually use my MySQL, my SendE one.
Okay. Okay.
These are real things that I use.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's start, stop, create. I've got my what do you call these? My endpoints. I can see the private and public as well as protocol all within Visual Studio. Now let's do. You show me the PowerShell one first.
Yeah. You want to do PowerShell? Yeah. Actually, do you want to do Crossplot first?
Okay. I'll do Crossplot.
Go Crossplot.
Okay. You're gonna try to challenge me.
Well, we'll see.
All right. Well, we'll see.
I'm trying to decide whether I'm gonna challenge you or not based on what you do.
Okay. So, I don't know what I'm gonna do. So, what you do when you want Crossplot is you say npm install azure-cli and then --g. That's for global, and -CLI is kind of a Node standard thing.
Yeah.
There's like grunt-CLI, azure-CLI.
Right.
There's actually an underlying library called Azure that this depends on.
Yeah.
NPM is the Node Package Manager. So Windows people just go to Node.js, download it, and it shows up in your path.
Mm-hmm.
Then you type Azure, and then you get this kind of cool ASCII art, which is nice.
That's, Star Wars
That
Azure.
Shows that we're serious.
Yeah.
That's what the ASCII art is about.
Right. We mean business.
Yes. And if you say Azure, it's basically, you know what it is? It's Azure noun verb.
Yep.
Azure VM list, Azure site list, Azure, Azure account, whatever. So I say Azure account, and then these are my account things. So basically you show up and you say Azure account download, and then it will go and actually launch a browser and then start downloading your subscription file.
Yep.
And then you say Azure account import the file name. And then Azure, if you have multiple subscriptions like I do, you then set the default.
Yep.
But from a virtual machine perspective, Azure VM gets me up here. So it's basically Azure VM verb. So I would say things like Azure VM list.
Shows you the whole list.
And that should show me the same list that we saw before there, although I've filtered it down because I'm only using the MSDN subscription here.
Ah, right. So only the ones deployed there. Yep.
That's the one that matters to
me.
And you can see the ones that we've made, including
exactly
Cori Forum.
So
there's Cori Forum, Azure VM stop Cori Forum. That's the one we made earlier. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, I'm never going to use it. Is it stop or shut down? Shut down. Next one's delete, so get ready for it.
I'm excited. I can barely contain myself.
And what's cool about this that I like is that it's a good way to see what's happening under the covers. If I say Azure VM list --JSON, you can kind of get a data structure.
It actually shows you the rest here. Yep.
Yeah. So Let's look at the one that we're deleting. There's Cori Forum, so I can see the IP address of it.
There you go.
And then there's the endpoints.
Yeah, how cool. Right, exactly. And this is such a great way to be able to sort of simplify management of lots and lots of machines.
Right. And I understand, I read on Scott Goo's blog that they're doing a library for .NET where mm-hmm. you can basically automate all these
and
things.
And program against it.
Right,
exactly.
From your
test. Instead of having to write PowerShell or node commands. Exactly.
Right.
Okay.
So I can say Azure VM. And I can also, this is the cool part, we saw in the earlier video about attaching disks.
Yep.
I can actually create disks
yep.
from the command line, attach them, do stuff with them.
Yeah.
And then get rid of them.
And then get rid of them. Yep.
Yeah.
Great.
So that's what I like about this one.
Shall I jump in here and show some PowerShell?
Yes. We type in PowerShell and we go to Azure PowerShell.
Great. All right, so you see from the PowerShell, obviously, we have sort of just the starting point to be able to show sort of all the commands that we've got available. They've formed sort of a similar rules around sort of the add and get. It's basically very PowerShell-esque rules.
Right, they do verb-noun.
Verb-noun, exactly.
Right.
So it's similar, but slightly different. And so what I'll do here, actually, let's just get out of this, is I'll go ahead and say add Azure account, and this is a very recent change actually, where you no longer have to do any certificate management. So just like Visual Studio, it'll sign right in, and so here this should sign in, and there we're good to go.
Okay. Oh, interesting. So it actually viewed all of my subscriptions.
It went ahead and signed them all in.
And then it says, and then it picked the first one.
Okay, great. So let me do this actually. So let me do just a get command and say Azure VM. I think that's the right command.
Well, see, this is what's cool about this stuff is that you can actually type, you can actually guess.
Yeah.
So I'm guessing like Azure VM. Remember I said stop and it was wrong. It was shut down.
Yeah, that's right.
You could probably type get Azure V and then hit tab. And then it would auto-complete.
That's right. So, exactly right. Oh, it looks like that was correct. Oh, this account doesn't have any VMs in it. So.
Oh, well, that's funny. Let's actually go back. It says to view subscription,
select Azure account. That's right.
Get Azure subscription.
There you go.
Exactly right. So I want that one. So then, select subscription?
Select subscription.
Select Azure subscription.
Yep.
Okay.
And then you can tap complete
select
that.
Select Azure subscription.
There you go. And then
subscription name. Okay.
Now let's do that get command.
Hit F7.
Yep.
How about that? That's a good one.
Look at this.
Someone was like, "Is that Windows 8?" I'm like, "No, it was actually DOS 4." But
there you go. And so you can see sort of the stopped and the start, right?
See,
so
now you're going to make me think I want to use the PowerShell. Yeah. Well, hang on. These are PowerShell objects then, so I can then sort them and select them and stuff.
That's right.
I noticed it came out
in
columns.
That's right. Exactly. So you end up, you can very easily pipe this into another set of commands, right? And so it allows you to do sort of that sort of piping.
Hmm. You see Cori Forum shut down.
That's right.
That I shut down the other DOS.
That's right. You just shut that down. So I can do, actually, let me do a new, and let me just say, shift complete this on a V, and basically, okay, great, new Azure VM. Let's call this Cori Forum better. VM 0, exactly. Cori is great. Okay. Oh, Cori is really great.
Cori does not know what he's doing.
Why are there so many?
Well, because you're talking about making a bunch of farmed VMs,
many
right?
Many options.
No, that's not how that works. So if we go and say, man, new Azure VM.
Looks like I lost.
What you're going to get it. That's okay. So the service name is like...
that's the group.
The group.
That's right.
So then, but when you do it from the command like that, there's no way to like skip out to the next one that I know of.
Right.
So you say dash, and then this is an array of VMs.
Oh, they just changed this, actually.
Oh, of course.
That must be the problem.
Because you can actually pass in a data structure that's an array of these persistent VMs.
I see.
You, let me ask you this, though. Can you delete that one?
We definitely can, yes.
Delete the one that I shut down here?
Yes, yep.
Is it just delete dash
yeah,
Azure
it just
VM,
be delete.
I'm
yeah,
guessing?
It should be, yeah.
Or remove.
Is it delete or remove?
See, these are the things you start.
See? There you go.
Once you start to learn the
verbs,
the isms.
Yep.
I guess it's
there
just
you go.
That.
Let's try this and let's say.
It's interesting. You like the interactive.
I do. Yeah. Great.
And I'm betting. Oh, see, that's interesting. So I'm guessing. Let me see if I can get rid of one of these. That if, and this is just guessing. We have no script here.
That's right.
That I bet I could. Let me go and open another one. I bet you that I could get a VM and pipe it through remove.
You can.
That would make sense.
That's
right?
Absolutely right. Yep.
So git Azure VM. Let's get rid of one of my Visual Studio ones, Hanselman Visual. Pipe remove.
And there you go. It's gone.
Okay, that one's gone already.
Yep. There you go.
Does that work?
Let's see if that one responds. Yeah. So you may not be.
Git.
Yeah. You may
Azure.
Not have been logged in the account. In that window.
Oh, you're going to have different accounts windows.
So let's see here. Get Azure VM.
Oops. What did we say? Hanselman Visual. So that makes that there you go.
And there you go. And now you can pipe that right in to remove
Azure VM.
Yep, that's right. And this is a great way, actually, when you're spinning up VMs.
Okay, all right.
You can create and then pipe them into create new additional endpoints or add additional disks.
Right.
So we see a lot of people who sort of create the VM and then immediately create add disks to it.
Right, and that's why I was teasing you a little bit on the command line that you were doing, because it'll put you in an interactive mode.
But that's not the way people really want to use PowerShell.
PowerShell wants you to pipe stuff
around. You're right.
Yeah, okay.
You've embarrassed me.
No,
it's fine. It's fine.
The part that the most significant about this that I like is that, and again, I use the XPLAT, you use PowerShell, is it's calling the same RESTful endpoints.
That's right. The back end is all the same, right? So, and so it's an open REST endpoint that you can also write to if you want to. And we do have a lot of partners who have written to the REST endpoint.
Right.
Yep.
And on the screen here now, there's this script center. And I just actually learned that this existed. There's ways that you can deploy entire farms.
That's right.
Like, I was very proud when I got my little 5 Linux machine working.
That's right.
Then I mentioned this to somebody, and he's like, oh, well, I did a complete SharePoint installation and one PowerShell script.
Exactly right. Yeah.
So it's just like, brrr, yep. and it made a bunch of stuff.
That's right. Actually, we've been working on these scripts for a little while, but you can see here for virtual machines specifically, right, you can go in and you can take this deployment script.
IIS front end, Mongo back end.
Yep.
Why? Because you can.
Exactly. Why would you not do this?
Yeah.
So actually, if you click, scroll down here.
Oh, okay. There's the code.
There's the code right there. And if you actually want to open it up, we open source all these. So scroll back up here and actually click on agree. Does that take you to the window here? Or you can actually just open it up. Scroll down from this window, actually, if you want to.
Okay.
There's the whole script right there.
Yeah, so they've built a function, basically, that then takes parameters and calls the other ones.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So then you can sort of see this is where. And the nice thing about this, and we've seen a lot of people do this, they pick these up and they actually make edits, right? They take them, they make them their own, right? And SharePoint script, we see a lot of people making a lot of edits, too, and building on top of.
Very cool.
Yeah, very, very cool indeed.
Scripting virtual machines. It's Azure Friday. Thank you.